Welcome to VCA Wrestling Lucha Libre. Let's get ready to rumble! Here in VCA. He'll line himself up with a brother, excuse me, with the greatest on earth. Babs getting a couple headlock shots in here. Showing off the head to the crowd here. Babs making sure to talk trash to the crowd. Dwayne firing up with that shot right there. Babs reverses, throwing Dwayne off the ropes this time. And a miss! Drop kick straight to the jaw. So my last reaction, starting things off here in BCA. Halloween Massacre. Builds a head scissors there, followed by a clothesline from Dwayne, called Mr. 1-2-3. Former Junior Beta champion that can score that pinfall on you. You at least expect it. It can happen at any moment in this matchup. Some tactics to be fully aware of. Spine buster with authority. Impressive athleticism from Tavis. Tavis coming way back up and a hard right hand to the face. Right-hand shots in the corner, bringing Dwayne down to his bottom there. That's the referee get out of the way with the boot straight to the face. Racing the forehead like a cheese grater. Vicious move there from Tavis. And Tavis used to be friends with Dwayne a while ago before Tavis came in. Turn on the brothers in arms, lying himself with the greatest on earth. Showing what side he's really on. Yeah, Dwayne way up in the air. Beautiful stalling suplex. Having some cover here. Two count the opening contest. Yelling, chewing in the face of Tavis. Tavis not too fond of that. He used to be a referee himself. Former referee of the year. Really outshined himself as a professional wrestler. The monkey flip. Tavis, far from a seasoned veteran, but a great upstart as a rookie. In his first year wrestling here in VCA, Dwayne shares a similar background with Tavis, being a former referee as well. Dwayne's had quite a rocky start in his rookie year. All cultivated when he won the Junior Beta Championship earlier this year. something that Tavis is yet to do, but I'm sure that vision board he has at home. Tavis making sure to talk trash to Dwayne's family at ringside. Tavis picking Dwayne up and mocking him. Hard right hand to the face. And Dwayne in the corner. Kick to the midsection there. Throwing Dwayne to the outside on the concrete floor.
What?
Get off! Get off!
Travis might be looking to get a count out victory here, but far from it. Dwayne gets back in the ring. I'm not going to go out like that. Travis with a snapmare for Dwayne. Come off the ropes here. Drop kick. Strong folded like an accordion there. Cover there. One, two. Kick out from Dwayne. Shot there from Dwayne. Right in the midsection. Firing back. Right hand shots there. Fires the lip. That was going up and over, but missed Dwayne. Dwayne psyched him out there. Going for that cover. Wait. Tavis has his foot on the ropes. Breaking the count. Tavis thought he was going to trap him with the up and over. Dwayne thought otherwise. This time, Dwayne saw it coming. I don't know if you saw that. Clothesline there from Tavis. Cover. Hard cover there. It's only a two count.
Hey, hey.
Referee letting them know you have to open that fist. No close fist allowed in professional wrestling. He's not seeming to care. Another right hand there. It's like a stiff one. With that slam! A belly to belly from Tavis. Beautifully executed. Going for a cover here. This time, Dwayne grabbing the ropes. Stopping the count with another rope break. These two men have got to finish it off in the center of the ring. Getting kind of victory here. Tavis throwing Dwayne to the corner there. Tavis inside, charging up at him. Dwayne gets out of the way. Wait a minute, rolling him up. This is how he gets it. One, two, three, that's it.
Ladies and gentlemen, here is your winner, Mr. 1-2-3, Dwayne.
Just like that, tickets to his namesake, Mr. 1-2-3, the pin out of nowhere. Big ups to Dwayne, his opening contest, your Halloween Massacre.
I was trying to get ready for the big match. And I was on the leg press.
and I had excruciating pain in my kneecap area. And I didn't know what it was, Spencer, because see, I know the gym is a place that people like Mike has never seen in his life. Just like the gym is not a place like many of you people never seen in your life. Now, if I was talking about Krispy Kreme donuts, a lot of people could relate. But now, yeah, you know when the hot light is on. Now, Mike, hold up. See, the thing is, I was on a leg press. I be trying to get my body in shape, unlike you, Mike, because you know nothing about that. See, look at you. You trying to come out here and jump on a handicap, Mike. You need to stop. Did your family teach you better than that? Now, how would you feel if somebody tried to jump on your... How would you feel if somebody tried to jump on your mama? She handicapped too. So you calm down. We handicapped people have to stick together. We have to stick together. Look, but I was going to rap to you, Mike. I was going to rap to you, I promise. Everybody know my heart. I'm not taking nobody's money. I was going to rap to you. But what happened is, after I felt that excruciating pain, I went and got an MRI on it. And they told me they could not believe that I walked in there like this. They said this is one of the worst cases they ever seen, Mike. This is the truth. Listen, this is the truth. They said this is the worst case they ever seen in their life. Because I walked in there. Because, see, I was trying to fight through the pain because I wanted to show everybody what happened to the people that step up to the Pharaoh. And, see, you want to be an example. Mike, would you please, Spencer, please get him back. Please. Look at my condition. Look at my condition, man. Look at my condition. Look at my pain. I hope you have insurance. I hope you have Obamacare because I'm about to use it. Now, I'm out of bed, I'm going to be like that. I'm hurt. I'm hurt. I'm meaning to get control to the muzzle on my mouth. I'm hurt. Because see, if I wasn't hurt, I'd come across that rail and smack the hell out of you. But see, I'm hurt. That's why I can't do what I want to do. That's why I can't do what I want to do. My million of fans are saddened by this occasion. They're like Big Red over there. She wanted to see me come in there and knock the hell out of you, Mike. But I can't do it. My mind wants to do it, but my body won't allow me to. The mind and the body are two different things. This was going to be the biggest night of your life. Which your life is not that big. Get off. Get up.
Another leg, you have another leg, it's working good
and fine. Oh, you want to fight me? Look at you trying to take advantage of a cripple. You want to fight me? And I'm on one leg, Mike? Are you serious? You are proving what I said before. You and your family have no home training. No home training. I don't know what your grandma taught you, but she didn't teach much. Because I would never teach my child to fight somebody handicapped. So, but my mic, this is what we can do. This is what we can do. We can do. I got a replacement. So what we're going to do, Mike, don't worry. You want to fight, right? You want to wrestle? Okay, I'm going to get somebody in the ring. Ladies and gentlemen, at this time, one half of the VCA Tag Team Champion. Come on out, Malik. Come on, big brother.
Underway. About to start right out of the gate. Doing what he has to do. All the way up there. Oh, that's a dog splash. Malik gets out of the way. Michael slides up. And... Malik choking Michael Clark up on the middle rope there. Almost breaking the five count. Getting himself disqualified. Headbutt there for Malik. Well, it was scheduled to be a singles contest between Michael Clark and Brooks. The contract was signed and everything. Here we are, hard subject to change.
No!
Michael Clark, those boots with the Irish whip here. Hard clothesline there. Taking Michael down, going for cover. Breaking the eyes there.
I can't.
Sleeper hold applied. And one half of the tag team champions, Malik.
I got it.
I'm gonna put Michael Clark to sleep early on in this contest. Michael's hoping to get in the ring with Brooks here. Brooks, he has an injury with his knee. He didn't actually disclose what kind of injury it was. I don't know if it's a torn ACL or broken kneecap, but he didn't really go into detail about that. So I don't know if he has that detail. Malik with that kitchen sink straight to the midsection. An elbow drop from Malik the Great, going for a cover.
I got something for you.
He just
has his crutch
in hand. Sitting up on my announce table with that wrap around his kneecap. Damn, I'm not really sure what he did to his knee. Said he was in the gym. I'm suspicious about this whole situation. Using that middle rope again to choke Michael Clark. That shot right there to the kidney. The tag team champion stomping away at Michael Clark.
Come pray for me. I'm hurt. Come on, please.
Michael up and throwing him out to the outside, but Michael holds on.
Pray for my knee.
He'll stand on the apron.
Pray for my knee.
Shoulder tackle there.
I'm hurt. If I want hurt, I'll be up in
there. Up and over Leo.
If I want hurt, I'll be up in there.
And that giant splash there in the center of the ring. Not enough to take him down, but enough to get a two count. Michael with a hard right hand shot. Forearm shot there to Malik. Malik throws him off and springs into a German suplex. My goodness. Impact there. And a cocky pin there from tag team champ, not enough, only gets a two. She's dropping him on the back of his head with that German suplex. Out of nowhere. Grabbing the face of Michael in the corner. Only grabbing the hair of Michael Clark. Rolling an elbow to the side of the head.
Hey, get over here. No. Come on,
here. Ban.
What are you talking about?
Malik.
Malik trying to start a fight with the fan when he's got a worthy opponent right there in the ring with him.
Midge!
I know Michael was not prepared to wrestle Malik here, but I wonder if Malik is preparing for this all week. Does have an experience edge. Well, I'm pretty sure he knew about Brooks' injury way before Michael got word. I guarantee you that. Malik with another sleeper hold here to Michael Clark. Trying to take Michael out. Michael not going to fade out that easy. Malik. Getting a tighter grip in with that sleeper hold. So Michael may be fading out here.
Let's go, Mike.
The referee counts to one. Two. One more left hand and it could be over. Wait. Michael's showing some signs of life here. That's here behind Michael with a jawbreaker there for Michael Clark. Breaking the grasp of that sleeper hold. Close line with a back elbow for Michael Clark. Irish whip to Malik. Malik reverses. Michael comes back. DDT. from Michael Clark. Spinning all around the head. Just to drop him on it. Beautiful technique there from Michael Clark. Michael rolling over, getting the cover here. Hooking the leg. Still only a two.
Come on, Malik. Shut up, lady. Come on, Malik. You can do it. Go on, take the trash. What? What? You gonna do what? I can fight you with one leg.
Here. Coming back. Grab him again. Back suplex. Going up and over. Handspring. Will he get him this time? He got him. Handspring back elbow from Michael Clark. Finally connects.
Get in there and do something, Spencer.
I'm not a wrestler. I'm an announcer. That's why I'm at my desk right now. The last thing I want to do is step in the ring between these two.
Shut up.
Michael Clark going for cover once again. Handspring back elbow proves not to be enough. A 20-plus year veteran, Malik.
Come on.
Michael up on his feet. Yeah. Malik, Malik with a rake to the eyes.
Put it on, Malik.
Fingers right in his eye socket. And Malik tumbling over the top rope.
Gotta watch my knee.
Brooks stood out of the way.
Get up here.
I'm not going to protect you, Brooks. Ooh. Malik can cross by the outside. Malik hits him with that right hand shot straight to the face. Brooks sitting around right above Michael Clark. Michael Clark heavy breathing there. Double shot there from Malik. Referee on five. Referee on six, getting closer to the 10 count. Oh, body slam on the concrete floor. Referee is on eight. I don't know if Malik even knows. Referee's on nine. That's it.
Ladies and gentlemen, here's your winner. Five count out.
Cut the music. Hold up.
You didn't get in the ring.
Hold up. Shut up.
You didn't get in the ring in time.
Well, what in the hell is wrong with you? See, this is a bad thing going on. First, Donald Trump gets the coronavirus in Malik and his crew. This is a bad thing. Malik, don't worry about it. See, Mike, this ain't over till I say it's over. Malik, don't worry about Malik. No, don't worry about it. Go ahead. This ain't over till I say it. We'll take that loss by count out. He didn't pin you. Watch my knee, Malik. Watch my knee. All right. We'll take that loss by count out. Everybody, ladies and gentlemen, give it up for Michael Clark, the winner of this match. We'll take that loss. He's the winner of this match by count out. Mike won this match. Give it up for Michael Clark, ladies and gentlemen. He won this match. We'll give you that one. Why do you keep calling for me in that ring fight? No, don't try to sit on the rope so I can come in there, dog, Mike. No. But I tell you what, get him back, ref. I tell you what, Mike. I must be Bob Parker because this is the Price is Right. We're going to see, since you want some more, I got some more. See, we're playing chess because I'm the king. And we don't stop making them in the king's family. We don't die, we multiply. Ladies and gentlemen, give it up for the Crown Prince. Sit down, people, sit down.
Hey, sit down.
Wait a minute, calm down. That's my number one thing. Calm down. It's all right. It's all
right. This is ridiculous.
Wait a minute. Mike, you want to fight. You got to fight. Calm down, Miss Joyce. Calm down. Calm down.
You got
to. You might break some. Sit down.
Okay. Mike, I'm going to let you fight the real British prince. I'm sorry. The crown prince.
Hey, Bob, I'm making some pancakes.
Perfect! Go ahead and take care of me.
We'll do this right now. Another impromptu matchup. We're going to do a one-on-one right here. Michael Clark versus the Crown Prince. We saw the Crown Prince return last week for the aid of the greatest on earth. Michael Clark used to be tag team partners with this man before they were forced to this man by the brothers in arms. Michael hasn't seen the Crown Prince since. Until this last week. Crown Prince came in and showed everybody exactly whose side he's on. Michael Clark a little upset and disappointed in his former tag team partner. Can't say he couldn't see it coming. Crown Prince with a clothesline to his former partner, Michael Clark. The one who's once referred to as a press prince is Michael. Chin lock there from the Crown Prince. And on the head all the way back in Michael Clark. A match no one saw coming. This one right here. Michael Clark thought he was going to get a match. There's Michael Clark biting the thumb of the Crown Prince. Michael Clark thought he was just going to fight Brooks here tonight. But instead he's left alone in a series of singles matches against his entire entourage. Michael's grandmother cheering him on at ringside. Crown Prince calls his grandmother. Michael Clark trying to show the Crown Prince. And spring back elbow there. Michael Clark looking to score an easy win here against the Crown Prince. It's a two count. Just defeated Malik via count out, but it's still a victory in the record books.
Come on, Crown Prince.
Ready to defeat both members. Grand Hunter's entourage here. Look at this, up and over. Where'd you learn all this? I am body slam. Kick out there from Michael. Michael just coming off of a fresh match there with Malik. Crown Prince having a word with Michael's grandmother. Down on the forehead of Michael. Come on now. Brooks is pointing to the crowd members. He's trying to get the Crown Prince to do. Jawbreaker there for Michael. And then Crown Prince down.
Crown
Prince back up on his feet. Michael, say, look at his eyes. A shotgun drop kicks in straight into the corner. Michael, Crown Prince in the center of the ring. What's he got?
Be quiet.
He's gonna go for it here.
Be quiet!
Michael going up top. He's gonna hit that frog splash. He gets it! Every ounce of it delivered. That's it. Ladies and gentlemen, here is your winner, Michael Clark. Oh, whoa, what? But you had a knee injury. I knew something wasn't right. You signed the contract. That's a fact. I didn't know he was going to do it like this. Michael not only threw his tag team partner, but threw his Michael's former friend, Brad Prince. A sneaky underhanded tactic from Brooks. Oh, he's fine. The wrap is nothing more than that, just a wrap around his kneecap. He's not injured at all. Hard right clothesline to Michael Clark. Stopped in the hand there. Michael signed that contract. Brooks signed on the dotted line as well. This match is made to be official. Here it is. I didn't think it was going to be in this capacity. Brooks right on top of Michael there in the side of those ropes. Ropes has a choking device. Underneath the ropes there, referee's dropping the count. Arms up there from Brooks. Michael comes back but gets that back elbow straight to the jaw. Oh. Brooks a real Grandpa Joe faking an injury until he finally gets what he wants. Dropping an elbow there. Landing directly on that so-called injured knee. But again, it's all just a ploy. You got Michael weakened up. Arse whip here from Brooks. Brooks charging in after him, but a back elbow there from Michael Clark. Michael charging in against the back of Brooks' elbow instead. And another stomp there to the hand. Brooks is talking trash to Michael's grandmother. And we're all used to seeing here Brooks scooping him up and dropping him on his ribs. Two count there. Michael with a dedication to win this. Brooks with that chin lock there to Michael Clark. Pulling the head back. Michael tapped out here. Fans pulling behind him. Use his energy from the crowd to get up. He will. Brooks taking advantage, grabbing the head, driving the turnbuckle. Fans by their chance, they can chant for whoever they like. The right hand shot there from Brooks. Michael, he looks a little fired up. Uh-oh. Michael ready for it. He's been through it all tonight. I'm not going to let Brooks stop him. Go for a swing, but this is Michael hits him with a back elbow. Brooks reverses. Another handspring back elbow. Holy cannoli. happen next here? Sending Brooks on his backside. Former Fresh Prince here mounting on top of Brooks. The right hands. Michael Clark drilling the head into the corner. Trying to get to the outside. Nope. Michael's gonna grab. He's not done with him yet. Doing his head once again to the turnbuckle post. Stops there. Takes the head next to the referee trying to back him up. Michael. Trying to get to his head. Wait a minute. Brooks has got something on the side over here. What's he doing? Whoa! Whoa!
Get a towel. Bring a towel and water.
Come on, Mike.
Come on, relax, Mike.
Come on,
relax.
See, can you see?
Mike.
See?
Are you able to see, Mike?
Oh, good.
Come on, Mike.
Yeah. You alright? He did call me a jail. I was knocked off last week. Because you want to talk stuff, boy. I bet there ain't no knockoff.
Come on.
Come on. I bet there ain't no knockoff.
Some more water on.
To see your face.
Come on, right.
Don't play with me. I told you. On, I said I will hurt you. So next time you step up to a man, remember this. And I don't care your family feels about it. I'll burn them too.
Come on, man. All right. He's gone, at least.
Who's that?
Mike, can you see?
My face, bro!
No, what? Somebody's supposed to be here, and Tim was supposed to be here. But you know what? He ain't even here. Because why? You know what? He ain't here because he's scared of me. You know what? He ain't scared of me. He's a blank in this ring with me. That's what. But since he ain't gonna be here, I ain't going nowhere. Cause I'm looking for a fight, and I want one right now. So all I gotta say is, who won?
Open challenge. Big motor.
Who won the fight?
Say. Need a referee out here. Need a referee. Getting pushed around by Big Motor. Drop kicks him into the ropes. Which isn't official yet. No referee in sight. Referee Jared. Referee in the back checking on Michael Clark. sure he gets the right medical attention back there. Doing a good job at being a referee. Let's call it another tie here in this next matchup here. Simba could not be here tonight. The Big Motor puts in an open challenge. Anybody who wants to step in the ring with him. I say this every week, the man with the biggest heart here in BCA accepts a challenge. Moving the entire ring. Shoulder tap straight to the ribs there. And shoulder block. Hear the impact down the street here on Winchester. Wayne not scared of anybody. He's been in the ring with the biggest. He's been in the ring with the smallest. He's not scared of anybody. No matter your size. Big Motor a little embarrassed. And shown out here by Dwayne. Nothing to be embarrassed about. I can tell you that much. Dwayne, the waist lock here. Gonna go for a shoulder strike, but elbow strike there, but Dwayne gets out of the way. Thanks to every move coming. Uh-oh. Well, we saw this. Driving him into the corner there. Dwayne doing anything he can. Get out of any hole. Whoa. Oh, and drop. Mowen dropped from the Big Motor. Dwayne already competed tonight against Tavis in the opening contest, so this is the second match for him. Only the second match, but he's in the ring with Big Motor. Big Motor going for a suplex here. We got all of it. Knocking the breath out of Dwayne. He's knocking the breath out of me, at least. Big Motor coming back. Dropping an elbow with a cover. Still have plenty of action to come later on tonight. Main event here, BCA Heavyweight Championship on the line. Tank going 1-1 against Johnny Ewing. In the Fatal 4-Way Contest last week. And with both men with the shoulders down the mat. Pin move. Big Tiny came out here and demanded the Heavyweight Championship be on the line here at Halloween Massacre. There will be a winner. It's a main event coming on later on tonight. Later on this month. The Booze and Body Slam, the two-night event, October 30th and October 31st is Halloween night. The Booze and Body Slam features former WWE Superstar Carlito. He will be there on Halloween night for Booze and Body Slams. Tickets are $20. It gets you into both shows. And $20 is admission into both October 30th and October 31st shows for Booze and Body Slams. In the ring here, Big Motor picking up Dwayne. Talking trash to him. Dwayne trying to swing and a miss. Big Motor got out of the way and a full Nelson here. Not a jawbreaker. Breaking the hole prematurely there. Back elbow there from Dwayne. Dwayne coming back off the ropes. For another back elbow, staggering the big man. Third one. Still only. Whoa! High! I was just about to ring the bell. He had him, 1, 2, 3, but chooses not to. Got him by his throat, picking him back up. Going again. Not going for the cover. Referee stopping the match. Ladies and gentlemen, your winner due to referee stoppage, Dwayne.
All right, you can stop it now. Throw
sure that's a disqualification caller. I'm not exactly sure.
He is wrestling out of Chicago, Illinois. He is the Chicago Kid, Kyu. And his opponent, he is wrestling from your wildest dreams. He is the current reigning and defending BCA Junior Native Champion, Daniel Moon. Fine. Ready to get things started here. Daniel Maddox, Chicago Kid Q. And last week, Daniel was in that fatal four-way contest. Chicago Kid Q saw it fit to come out and interfere in that matchup. Call Daniel Miraculous that shot of the heavyweight title. Daniel putting his own title on the line here. Daniel going to the outside. Junior made a championship on the line, but Daniel might be looking for a countout victory or loss here. He loses by countout. He'll still retain that Junior made a championship. I don't know if that's his plan. It seems like he's getting more ready. Taking off the vest and the wig. Daniel slightly more serious in his demeanor here tonight. He might be fed up with Chicago Kid Q already. To the outside. I don't know what Daniel's trying to do. Daniel back in the ring here. Chicago Kid Q on the outside. This is those mind games that Daniel's so good at. Getting in the head of him. Daniel on the outside here, rolling out once again. Daniel wants to get in the ring. The only way Q can win this match is if he pins Daniel or submits him inside the ring. Well, Daniel sees the opportunity. Goes out of here. Rolling shots to Chicago Kid Q. Daniel more than mad. Cost him that match last week. Daniel could be heavyweight champion right now if it wasn't for Q. Daniel has every right to be angry, but this is I don't know if this is the appropriate response. Get up, Q! Get up! Get up! Get down! Get up!
grudge. Cares if you walk out of here alive. Goodness gracious. Everybody having to check on the well-being of Chicago Kid. Daniels Jr. getting a championship on the line. Shots. I don't think I've seen Daniel throw shots any harder than he is right now. Daniel picking Q back up on his feet. Irish whip here, Q coming back. That's the clothesline. Gets him up, gets out of it. Puts the back. Big back elbow there from Daniel. Just when Q is trying to get back, get the momentum back on his side. And it sets him out real quickly. Daniel circling around his prey. Figuring out what the next move here is going to be. Look right in the back of the head of Q. Letting go at four. Layden was choking right in front of the referee. Gets up right before the count of five.
Oh, it's just inside.
You gasping for air there in the ring. Jawbreaker there from Q. Big jawbreaker. They're staggering Daniel Miraculous. On the ropes. Daniel right behind him. Big clothesline. I mean, Q's got a bit of offense in this whole matchup. It's been all Daniel this entire time. Junior Bait of Champion showing who's in charge. Reason he's Junior Bantam champion, one of the best wrestlers here in BCA. No one can take that away from him. He's also going up against Chicago Kid Q, Wrestler of the Year, 2019 Charlie Award winner. He won multiple awards at the Charlies last year. That doesn't mean he's going to win the Junior Bantam title. He's in the ring with Daniel Miraculous. Daniel's going to make sure of that. A hard shot there from Daniel. Going for an Irish whip here. Big splash there. Daniel misses. Then he caps it there. Not enough. First line of offense in this matchup from Q. He gets him hard. He gets him good. Come up the ropes here. Daniel's looking to throw an arm there. Whoa! Manny Hess is drilling Daniel into that corner. Rolling neck breaker there from Q. Moonberg, another cover. Daniel kicking out at two. Looks like Q's back in this. Eddie State claimed back that Junior made a championship. A title that once belonged to him in the past. Oh, Daniel catches him. Locks that shot. He gets a shot right in the zone. Daniel scaling up top. We're up at the top rope. Whoop. Q joining him. Right behind him. Going for that superplex. Daniel holding on for dear life. Shots there to the kidneys. Whoa! Dropping him face first. The middle of the ring. Face first, he just fell. Wait a minute, he's not. Lindsey Gurry Chicago Kid Q. When he thought he was out, he brings him back in. Superflex. That's not it. Picking him back up. Falcon Arrow. It's all of it. Running attempt there only gets a two count. Not enough. They counted the two count there. Not enough. Duke just a second away from winning the junior belt championship. Hard right hand chop there. Irish here, Daniel. Going into the turnbuckle post. Q right behind him, charging in after him. Whoa, Daniel picks him up. Whoa. Dropping him on the back of his head, right across his knee. KQ should have stayed down when Daniel told him to. It's a knee strike right to the side of the head. Daniel picks Q back up, gave him that full Nelson face buster. That could be all she wrote. No, only a two. Not enough to put down Q. Daniel picking Q back up. Right hand shot. Falling back into that corner there. Alright, Q reverses. Daniel dodging that turnbuckle. Right boot there from Daniel. Miraculous. Fully connects. One, two. Not enough. Another two from the Chicago Kid Q.
Come on, Phil. Come on, boy.
Daniel with his hands around the throat of Q. Hard knuckle strike there. Not a legal move.
Very good.
White boots there. And Daniel just toying with Q. Tried to catch him, Q. Rolled him around, outsmarted him, hits him with a sling blade. Rolled him in down and out. Knocking Daniel down, trying to roll him over for that cover. Gets him around, pin. Only a two. Referee's just a hair away. Hair away from that three. He was picking Daniel back up. Junior Belt Championship on the line. This is my main event here in Halloween Massacre. Step up, DDT didn't get it at all. Q pushing away. Q two. Irish whip to Daniel. Daniel reverses. She's going to the corner, up and over. Daniel comes back. She's going to the corner, up and over. Daniel comes back. Super kick laying out Daniel Miraculous. Could we see a new Junior Vader champion? One, two. Oh! Shoulder. The shoulder was up. Shoulder got up right the last split second. Referee informing Q that was only a two, got the shoulder up. Right as his hands have about to hit through the three, Daniel got his shoulder up. Ureda. We get another super kick here. Will he connect with it? Daniel gets up. Oh, a knee strike! Ducks a super kick, hits him with a knee. Oh. Striking him with these elbows. Q responding. Q is out. Q is out. Daniel step up. DDT. Q is out. Daniel step up. DDT. That's gotta be it.
Ladies and gentlemen, here is your winner, and still the PCA Junior Vader Champion, Daniel Miraculous.
Shots to the back of Q. Driving the chair into the chest. Hey, stop, stop, stop. What the hell's wrong with you? What the hell's wrong with you, Daniel?
What has gotten into you? Come on. You got a family.
You're doing too much. It's in your ribs.
Yeah, I'm good.
Ridiculous. Oh.
Ladies and gentlemen, the following contest is your main event of Halloween Massacre, and it is scheduled for one fall, and it is for the BCA Heavyweight Championship. Introducing first to my left, he's being accompanied by Uncle Calvin from Memphis, Tennessee, the Memphis Cowboy, Johnny Ewing. And his opponent to my right, he is one half of the Brothers in Arms. He is manufactured in Wynn, Arkansas. He is no man, for he is Tay.
BCA Heavyweight Championship on the line. We've been waiting 184 days to crown the next BCA Heavyweight Champion. We are guaranteed a winner here tonight. One of these two men, Johnny Ewing or Tank's, gonna walk out of here with the BCA Heavyweight Championship here at Halloween Massacre.
Ring the bell.
And we're off. Main event time. Johnny Ewing and Tank one-on-one for the BCA Heavyweight Championship, not what we originally had planned. That fatal four-way last week to determine the new heavyweight champion, but after Tank got Johnny in a small package pin attempt, both men's shoulders are down on the mat. The referee thought it was Tank. Someone else thought it was Johnny Ewing. The owner of Big Tiny came out here and declared a singles match to determine who'd be the rightful winner. Let's see who gets it fair and square here tonight. Johnny Ewing Irish whips that Tank. Oh. He's going for a clothesline there, but Tank cuts him off. Goes out to the midsection. Going for a cover here early on. Gets a two count. And Johnny Ewing. Two's not bad in the first minute. Right hand shot there from Tank. Made that two of them. Putting Johnny Ewing in the corner. I spoke to Tank in the back. And how ready are you for tonight? Singles match for the heavyweight title. He's never been ready for any match more than he is tonight. Tank's been living for this moment. Finally, a one-on-one shot for the heavyweight championship. Johnny Ewing with a splash there in the corner, laying Tank out. They can Tank back up. Going off the ropes. Big kick there from Tank. Laying Johnny Ewing down. Tank coming in. Whoa! Step up Hurricane Rana from Tank. Johnny Ewing didn't see it coming, huh? I didn't either. Side headlock takeover. Got Johnny down on the mat. Johnny shoulder up. Not a pin here. Wait a minute. Going Tank over. Now it's a pin attempt, but Tank gets out of it. Right in the nick of time. Got this headlock applied in tightly. Johnny Ewing picks up Tank. Tank floats over his back. Back Johnny Ewing goes straight to the outside. Hits the side of the ring hard. Heard the thud right here. Baseball slide. Johnny Ewing out, laid out here on the concrete. With his manager, Uncle Calvin, standing right above him. Can't win the championship on a count out. Whoa! Suicide dive! Laying Johnny Ewing out. I don't know if you've ever seen a tank fly, but you just seen one here tonight. I want to thank everybody for watching, whether it be on Australia TV, Saturday mornings at 11, on our Facebook channel, or YouTube channel, later on in the week. I encourage everybody to watch BCA exclusively first on Australia TV, every Saturday morning at 11, channel 17.1, on those satellites. Johnny Ewing, lock here, oh! Slamming him into that turnbuckle. That belly to belly. He's dropping right there on the top of his head. Dropping that right boot down on the head of Tank. Johnny Ewing, been a former heavyweight champion himself. He won it before. Tank's never held that gold. Johnny Ewing knows what it's like to be heavyweight champion. Have that target on your back. Be the top dog in the company. Johnny doesn't care about any of that. As long as he has that gold, that's all he cares about. Doesn't matter who's after him. He's going to step in the way and stop them in their path. What he plans to do with Tank right here. Stop him in his tracks and grab that heavyweight championship. This might see that here tonight. Tank getting back up on his feet. Right hand shot there from Johnny. Laying Tank out. Johnny saying it's an open palm shot. I don't know if I believe that to be true. Struck him a little too fast for referee to even judge. That was close hand or open fist. Johnny Ewing, the blatant low blow. Right in front of the referee. Referee is the new champion just as much as the rest of us, letting it slide, but just this once, for the well-being of Tank. I don't know if he intentionally hit him below the belt there. We're all going to say he did, though. A chop and a fist there. Repeated shots in the corner there. Laying Tank out. Uncle Calvin on the side of Johnny Ewing for better half of a year now. Uncle Calvin guarantees gold for every person he manages. He's going to promise us that here tonight. Johnny Ewing has a heavyweight championship. Now it's just all up to him to capture it. High. On the turnbuckle. Square in the forehead goes that elbow. Johnny Ewing talking trash to the fans, and he should be focused on his opponent. Heavyweight title's on the line. You gotta be more focused than that. Bullseye Tim nearly misses, and a cross face from Tank. A cross face in the middle of the ring. Johnny Ewing tap out. Really tap. Johnny trying to, he's trying to crawl to the side here, trying to get a hold of that rope. Tank's got it wrenched in tight. Reapplying the locks with his fingers. There's no way he's letting go of this one. Johnny crawling closer and closer to that rope. Uncle Calvin pushing that rope towards him. I don't know if that's legal. Uncle Calvin not directly involved in contact. Referee not going to stop it. Tank getting back up to his feet. Crossface gives us one Johnny Ewing out. We'll see here. Irish whip attempt. Johnny gets out of it. A big boot there to the face. Second Johnny Ewing back. Tank all the way to the top rope. Johnny hits him with that strike to the side of the head there. He's scaling up there too. Wait a minute. Wait a minute. Whoa. Holloway slam. Throwing Tank all the way across the ring. A massive power from the Memphis Cowboy. Would that be it? Rolling Tank over. Gets him on his back, shoulders down. One, two. Two count, not enough. The referee says it was a two. I saw two as well. Johnny Ewing thought he might have had him down with that one. He had to try a little bit harder. Take out the machine. Throwing Tank all the way over the top rope, crashing hard to the floor. Johnny having a word with the referee. The referee talking to Johnny. Calvin on the outside with that cane. Strike to the jaw. Tank laid out in front of him. From my announce table here. The benefit of Uncle Calvin. Uncle Calvin grabbing Tank. Pushing him back in the ring. Johnny Ewing complaining about a toothache that he's had for the better part 3 years now, allegedly. And sick of this. Blatant cheating tonight. It's going to irritate me. Whoa! Two count there. Tank kicking out at two. Out to announce the new BCA heavyweight champion tonight. Who's it going to be? Tank or Johnny Ewing? Johnny's got Tank right there in the center of the ring. I want to take this time to let everybody know that we have a special two-night event, booze and body slams. That's Friday, October 30th, and Saturday, October 31st is Halloween night. Halloween night, we will have former WWE superstar Carlito in the house. It's October 30th and 31st for booze and body slams. Tickets for $20 to get you into both shows. Again, $20 admission gets you into both shows, October 30th and 31st. Back to the action here. Johnny Ewing back up on his feet. Tank still laid out here. Tank trying to get up, grabbing onto the knee pads, onto the singlet. We need to help him get back up on his feet. Johnny Hewitt was just mocking Tank right in front of him. Headshot there. Yeah, headbutt. Well, Calvin's on the bus that had it open. Looks like a two count. Uncle Calvin's a little bit obstructing my view here. Thought I had the best seat in the house, but Uncle Calvin decided that wasn't going to be the case. Jawbreaker there. From the machine. From a beautiful disaster. Disaster indeed. This is completely in a mistake from Johnny Ewing. Right to the side there. Massive leg drop. Former heavyweight champion. Could it be the new heavyweight champ? Only a two. Not enough. Probably just a moment away from crowning new heavyweight champion. Not the case. Tank in desperate need some help here. Tank one half of the brothers in arms. Chicago Kid Q. Just had that match with Daniel Miraculous earlier for the Junior Vader Championship. A big night here for the brothers in arms. They're going after the singles gold here. Q is unsuccessful in capturing that Junior Vader Championship. That doesn't mean anything for Tank. Tank could very well win the heavyweight title. Nice to overcome Johnny Ewing right here. Johnny Hassel five to let go of that count. He knows it. Dropping this clothesline down. Go for another cover here. Tank slowly making his way back up. Johnny Ewing just looking down at him. Again, mocking Tank. Johnny Ewing's been talking about the heavyweight championship. For over 180 days, Johnny Ewing's been looking to capture this heavyweight title. Pretty do it right here. Kick out at two. A big win this could be for Tank. If he can just get the momentum back on his side. Uh-oh. Torture rack. Tank gets out of it. Kicks him. 12 packs. We saw this last week. There from Johnny Ewing. A lot of movement to this seat from the big man. Getting a first-hand look at the action here. Monster Big Tiny. And Ramona of BCA Wrestling. Looking over at Uncle Calvin. Making sure. He's going to make sure this goes down clean. It was no funny business from Uncle Calvin. I don't blame him. It's the heavyweight championship here. A title that got stripped from Big Tiny in the first place. He wants to make sure there's a clean winner here. Torture rack from Johnny Ewing. Wait a minute. He gets out of it. Comes that slip. That's it. Ladies and gentlemen.
Machine!